Hey, we the Hebrew Israelites come out week in and week out. Prophesy the downfall of this wicked kingdom of America, man. First of all, I want to give all praise to the Heavenly Father and Son, Yahweh, Baal, Yahweh Shai, and double honors to the apostles, the elders, the GMS, who rule well, and peace and blessings to the hopeful elect. Right? We out here for the elect and elect only of the 12 tribes of Israel, Judah, the so-called Negroes, Benjamin, the so-called West Indian Jamaican, Levi, the so-called Haitian, Reuben, the so-called Seminole Indians, and of the North American Indians, Issachar, the so-called Mexicans, Zebulon, the Guatemalans, and Panama, Manasseh, the so-called Cubans, Simeon, the so-called Dominicans, right? Ephraim, the so-called Puerto Ricans, Ashes, Colombia, the Uruguay, Naphtali, the Argentina, the Chile. These are the 12 tribes of Israel who our big brother is saving. Yahweh Shai has come to redeem 1/3 of the elect and 2/3 to set up for the destruction. In Israel, Israel is the chosen of the Most High, man. You know, they are the chosen of the Most High. They are that special people. Exodus 4:22, and thou shalt say unto Pharaoh, thus saith the Lord Yahweh, Israel is my first son, even my firstborn. So Israel, within a whole, is the firstborn of the Heavenly Father. His firstborn being Yahweh Shai, the Savior. You know, Yah meaning he, Yahweh Shai is the deliverer, man. He is the firstborn. He is the top Israelite, man. That's who's coming back to redeem us out of this situation that we're in this place, America, man. The Savior, man, Yahweh Shai, he's coming to redeem us, man. He's on his way back, man. You know, Israel being his chosen. Deuteronomy. Book of Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy 7:6. For thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy power. The Lord thy power have chosen thee to be a special people unto himself above all people that are upon the face of the earth, man. So he said that you are a holy people. When you go into that word holy, it means separate, man. Consecrated, man. So we are separate from all these other nations, man. You know, it's 18 nations, man, on the planet, man. Israel being the top nation. Firstborn of Yahweh, man, the one he chose to be his people. It says, chosen as a special people unto himself, meaning we're set apart with that special treasure, man. If when you have a treasure, what do? You guard that treasure, man, with your life, man. You know, you love that treasure, man. So the Lord said Israel is this special people, meaning his special treasure, man. Within that special treasure, there is a special treasure within that treasure, which are the elect, man, who Yahweh Shai is coming to redeem, man. It says, the Lord did not set his love upon you, nor choose you, because you were more in number than any people, for ye were fewest in number of all the people. So the Lord works in small numbers. When you go back to the time of the Maccabees, he used war, he used small amounts of people, man. Even told Abraham to take 300.
Right. Jimmy Lunsford, you're one of the running business while you step over here. You know what? I love hearing your word. Right. Thank you.
You've been over here.
Yeah, I got a lot of walking steps made from drip water.
You've been ordering, like, you've been running the whole building?
No. Here.
Oh,
come
okay.
Don't miss out here. I just want to say thank you for preaching the word.
All right, man.
Music to my ear.
All right, brother. All right, man. Hey, like, I'm going to read that again. It says, for thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy power. The Lord thy power have chosen thee to be a special people unto himself above all people that are upon the face of the earth. So the Lord set Israel to be above everybody, man. But you know, you have Edomites, man. They say they love to hear that word, but it'll tell more and more when they keep coming out. You know, because he left, hey. Like, you know, you try the spirit by the spirit, but you know, they say, hey, whatever, man, it's probably Edomite anyway. But but like I normally be a little bit further down. They all right there in my spot, so I had to come down a little bit. But you know, hey, I ain't tripping because this word gonna go out, you know, it's all good. It says verse 7, Deuteronomy 7:7. The Lord did not choose his set his love upon you, nor choose you because you were more in number than any people, but you were in the fewest of all people. So the Lord works in those small numbers, like I said, in the time of the Maccabees, man. We had to fight those wars, the Maccabean revolts, man. They didn't have a lot of people, but they went up against like thousands, man. So the Lord will take a small number and defeat a big number to show you his power. And plus to show his people, if you call on my name, what the way I will help you, man. And that name is what? Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, man. Yahweh meaning what? He exists. Yahweh Shai is he is the deliverer, man. The Lord will show you his power if you call upon him, man. That's why he said I didn't choose you because if it was more in number, then the people would praise themselves of being more in number. But when it's fewer in number, you know that you had to have help, man. You know? What's up, man? Hey, you know you're Israelite? You didn't know you're Israelite? Never seen that before?
I've heard of Israelite.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's what we are. Our whole nation. That's our nationality. Because you ask somebody, what's your nationality, right? If they don't know, get what they're going to say. I'm black or I'm white.
Oh, that's a black.
Yeah, because there ain't nobody black. We brown, but we different shades. See, that's that stigmatization they put on us, like you black. Now, if you see the dude that color, you wouldn't even get next to him. You see what I mean? Your shirt black.
Yeah.
So that's a byword. There's a curse. And the curse in Deuteronomy, the Lord said the Israelites are beyond. That's probably like a byword. That's like a degrading word.
Yeah.
Because black means what? Darkness, void of knowledge. So when they call us that, they telling us you ain't got no knowledge. Or when they call themselves
lucky.
Yeah, they call themselves well, you're unlucky. Yeah. So when they call themselves white, they're saying they're more pure,
yeah,
more of knowledge than us. But no, that's those are all lies. Those are what they call strongholds when you're reading the book of Corinthians. So brothers, you see brothers out here as such as myself, you go on YouTube, you type in like Hebrew Israelites or more, just type in Great Millstone, you'll see brothers that's preaching the word. Because we in that time where this whole system is finna crash.
Yeah.
Right? And the Lord finna lift up the people who we loved in the beginning, which are in slavery right now, which is us. So he getting ready to bring us back to a miraculous power, to a miraculous way, through what they call chariots, the thermonuclear destruction. Yeah, he finna have these countries basically bomb America, right? But he gonna lift us up out of here. If it's his will, the ones he chosen, he gonna lift us up out of this place, like just like Star Trek. You remember Star Trek?
Yeah.
When they used to say, beam me up, Scotty.
Yeah.
They get the little cell phone. They had cell phone back then. You remember?
Yeah.
And then they say, beam me up. And they go stand in one spot.
Yeah.
And then the beam would come down. And then would deterioralize their body. And they would vanish. And then they would show up on the ship. See, the Lord, they got that from the Bible. So the Lord is getting ready to do the same with us. He's getting ready to come back and redeem us out of this captivity.
Yeah.
But we've been in America, 500 some years. Because you have, let me show you right here. See, when you go through the captivity, you have the Babylonians, right? We were in captivity like 70 years under them. Then when the Lord, he had certain prophets that prophesied during that time, Daniel, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, prophets and such. He had the Medo Persians come in and destroy them through war. That knocked that whole empire out. They ain't never came back. Now, when the Persians ruled, right, they had a vast amount of land. Then he had the Grecians, which was Alexander, which was so-called white man.
Yeah.
Boom, knocked them out. Then he had the Grecians. During the Grecians, whites was warring against the whites. And that's when that Roman period came in. Then Rome fell in 193 AD. We took over what they call the Dark Ages. But you never, when we was in school, they never would preach about the Dark Ages. They would just say, they would just say, oh, it's a bad time in history, medieval times. Nah, that's when we ruled. From like 325 all the way up to 1300. Then they came back into power in 1300, which is called Renaissance. white man took back over in like 1356. And he's been in power ever since then. And through that power, he put the peoples on that side in slavery.
Yeah.
Basically, he put the whole world on the, you know what I mean? Because right now, the whole world, they call it the American way. The way everybody in every other country wants to come to America to live. Because they figure I can come over here and make money. I ain't gotta be on them strict rules of my own country.
Yeah.
You know, some countries you got a woman have to like walk behind a man so far, but when they come over here, they don't do that. See, America pollutes what they call a philosophy. We call it the wine in the Bible. You drink of that wine of Babylon. This is Babylon. If you drink of that wine of Babylon, meaning if you come over here and you be right with their system.
Yeah.
Which a system promotes homosexuality. Bestiality, you got women marrying dogs and shit. They have sex with their dogs. You got women marrying women, men marrying men. So how we gonna procreate and live longer? So the Lord got us sending his son down here to get us out of this situation. Cause when we were in our kingdom, we had everybody under subjection. Everything was ruled the right way. We had all our women's, we had multiple wives, cause we had families, you know, all that was going on, but we disobeyed, right? I'm gonna show you right here. This Deuteronomy, these are the curses. It says Deuteronomy 28:15. It says, but it shall come to pass, meaning it ain't happen, it will happen, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy power, meaning listen and do what he tell you, to observe and do all his commandments and his statutes which I commanded this day, that all curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. Right? So they're going to pursue and overtake you. You basically won't be able to escape it until the Lord send his son back. And it says, cursed shall thy be in the city, and cursed shall thy be in the field. So cursed these Israelites, right? These Israelites, wherever they at, they're going to be cursed. That's just like, you already know if you go to the west side, you know if you're in a black neighborhood, you know when you're in a white neighborhood.
Yeah.
When you're in the black neighborhood, you see the like cars and shit on the ground, the fucking oil in the street, ain't no grass in the yard, cigarette butts everywhere. You know, you see what I'm saying? When you go in, when you enter into a Israelite neighborhood, because Puerto Ricans live poor too. Mexicans, they live just poor as anybody else.
Well, like, mean like poor?
Yeah, like, you know, like, as a nation. Yeah, when you see like, if you go to Charter Guard, you know what's in there. You know it's going to be these people here. When you ride by, you know, but when you ride by rich neighborhood, you know, that's the, Esau is living in his heaven right now. Like, one man heaven is the next man hell. You done heard that before. He living in his heaven, because he owned the banks. He owned everything you see down here, a so-called white man owns. Owned the top banking family, Esau.
Yeah.
They are the Rothschild, so-called white man. They own everything. So these banking families, they have all the Israelites because it's just their time, because the Lord has it that way.
Yeah.
But he has it where their time is getting short, where they got to go down again, and they got to go back into subjection under us again. And that's why we out here. You see, brothers, in every state in the United States, we in Mexico, South America, or Germany, all Europe, brothers in Hawaii, it's going to be a small number. Brothers is preaching, man.
Yeah.
Because the gospel say got to be preached to the end for the end to come. So you got, through the internet, we able to preach and put it on film.
Yeah.
I go put this on the internet.
Yeah.
Even though you hear me, when I put it out there, thousands of people going to see it.
Yeah.
That way, in hopes that one brother might wake up. The angel rejoices that one brother get this. Because it's always a small number. That's how the Lord show you his power. A small number. He even said in that day, in Leviticus 26, he tell you that he going to give us a power that you're going to be able to put 100 men to flight. You're going to be able to fight 100 men in one time with all of them. That's in Leviticus. But see, when you go into church, they're not teaching you that. They just teaching you, they playing songs, and they clapping, and they hollering amen, and they passing that plate around. You know what I'm saying? You went to church before. I did too. We grew up in there.
Yeah.
We grew up, man. Grandma'll snatch you by the ear, take you to church, man. I went through the same. We went to church together, man. We've been through that together. So you know what I'm talking about. You know I'm not lying. And that's what they do. They'll pass a plate around 3-4 times. But like the Lord said, and this is the last days we in. He said this right here. This is Jeremiah 3. I'm going to go back to them curses. Jeremiah 3 and 15. I will give you pastors according to my heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. So this is the last day. So he give you the pastors. He's sending brothers out here. We've got the understanding through learning from men that the Spirit is on. We learn the true characteristics of the Lord, because they think the Lord is all love and he have no emotion. Well, if he didn't have no emotion, why would people die? He caused that.
Yeah.
He caused life and death, right? Matter of fact, when I said that, let me edify that. Because he calls it the life and the death. This 1 Samuel. Samuel, the first chapter, the 6th verse. Two or six. It's a lot. 2 and 6. Yeah, 1 Samuel 2:6. The Lord killeth and he maketh alive. He bringeth down to the grave and he bringeth up. So the Lord killeth and he maketh alive. So when a baby born, the Lord did it. When the baby died, the Lord did it. When you hear somebody getting shot 10 times with a Uzi, the Lord did that. Because the issues of death, they tell you right here, Psalm 68. Psalm 68:20. It says, he that is our power is the God of salvation. And unto the Lord Yahweh belongeth the issues of death. So when he's sitting on the throne, he needs you dead, right? Go back to Psalm. This is what he do when he wants you dead. Back to Psalm. Well, I just left Psalm. Psalm 79. Psalm 78 and 49. He cast upon them fierceness of his anger, wrath, and indignation. You look that word indignation up, it means righteous anger. The anger that he put forth is righteous, right? So it says, in trouble by sending evil angels among them. So when the Lord is sitting on the throne, he got the Son sitting on this side, right? Who the world England called Jesus, right?
Yeah.
But in the Hebrew, his name is Yahawashah.
Yeah.
Right? That's the true name you call on. Over here, he got Satan sitting on this side. Right? So when he needs something done, you know what, dude, been doing a lot of, you know, bad stuff. He said, his time is up, basically. So he don't look to this side, because this is the righteous side. He'll look over here to Satan and say, hey, I need that spirit. So Satan will go get his evil angels, and angels will come down here and make it happen, man. Make it happen.
Yeah.
They'll make it happen. They take you out, or they can save you, you know.
Yeah.
You might be in a bad car wreck, and they be like, man, dude got killed that was driving, passing, then get a scratch. That it wasn't your time, so the angel was sitting in there holding you back. All of the destruction, when the car flipped, he held you in place. He didn't dent that side of the car.
Yeah.
That's how that works, you know. Lord is cold.
Looking at it like,
yeah,
like,
Lord cold too, man.
Wow.
You know, he cold, man. And that's how that thing goes, man.
Yeah.
The angels protect you, you know. I go back to them curses. But we in that day, so we come out here to prophesy against this place.
Yeah.
So this is that sinful kingdom.
You be out here a lot?
Every week at this time. Sometimes I'm a little bit late.
Where you from? North Little Rock or Little Rock?
Yeah, we from the other side.
North? Yeah, all right.
Let's see, Amos. This book of Amos. Check this scripture out. Amos 9 and 8. It said, behold, the eyes of the Lord power, right? So that word God is in caps. So when I'm reading them, when I read it, I'm probably gonna say the name, but sometimes if people hear they don't know, I'm gonna say God.
Yeah.
You know, because he said, don't give pearls to the swine. I can't just give everybody that name because they're not Israelites. They're heathens and shit. We Israelites. You see what I mean? If you sit here and listen to this word, I can throw that nugget on you to help you out. When you pray to that name, the Lord give you that knowledge. When you pray Yahweh in the name of Baha Shem, Yahweh Shai.